President of ICWAI, Sanjay Barua, Ashok Nawal, and David Joshi, and Kanya Haji, and MPFK, the Abhi Dante, and all the student members and practitioners. Friends, I am indeed delighted to participate in the Golden Jubilee Emergence of the Institute. Of cost and wealth acceptance of India. My greetings to our leaders, all the members of ICWAI, casting scientists, investigators, economic planners, and the district guests, and particularly about 300 students of India. The topic I have selected. I don't know whether you will be happy. The topic is selected. Motto for ICWAI. Motto. Promote. Motto for ICWAI. Promote. Profit with integrity.
Okay.
finally get the fellow magnet to up to the place of the work. Right in the heart, only three people can you can guess, can you get? Mother, right, mother.
Progress is visible in many
want to do their rights, but to the development actions. Still, we have to overcome certain bottlenecks. Despite the political vision, well articulated schemes, and the adequate fundings, many major programs are not on schedule, and the benefits are not reaching the intended beneficiaries. How can we reverse this trend through better organization, better transparency, better feedback, better visibility of timely action, purposeful accounting and auditing? Now, I would like to share with you two of my personal experiences. Now, I know what is at the technology side. I look at the technology side, I look at the accounting side, I look at the auditing side. Let me first give you an event-based experience of the recent program, which is similarity to the vision of auditing and accounting. When I see the role of two cost controllers, I am reminded of a technical event taking place in sequence in the case of a flight trajectory, the missiles flying. Let me refer to rockets flying. Let me refer to the launch of any missile system. We need a control and guided flight from time of launch till it reaches the target at launch rate 2,000 km. At TPO, we are starting. The time of launch, automatic launch control system, gives the takeoff signal after testing more than 600 parameters by computers in few seconds. If all the parameters are within the specified error band, computer gives a go-ahead signal. The missile gives up. The missile has an onboard computer that carries a special trajectory, which is to be followed by the missile from time to time. It lifts off till it reaches the specified impact point. Any deviation from the trajectory is detected and quantified by the computer and fed continuously to the control system on the inside. The control system operates fast reaction thrusters in all the three axes of the flight and corrects the deviation, brings the missile to the right on the required trajectory in real time. If the corrective action is not done, then in real time, the mission will be far away from the target and the mission will be free. Time is controlled with its onboard computer acts as the brain of the missile. During the flight of the missile, it is essential to guide the missile in real time to the target to meet the mission requirements and succeed. From this guided mission flight example, I'd like to share the following experience. As you can see, if the correction is provided after the event is over, the mission will not succeed. Correction, whatever correction you do, the mission will not succeed. That is, as you can see, if the correction is provided after the event is over, the mission will not succeed. Follow?
Yes.
Similarly, if the cost controllers, the cost controllers' recommendation and delay beyond the completion of the event, they see that they have to play to correct. Already committed. All the problems committed. What is the use of your story in that problem? I'm sure you can realize the importance of providing online cost control advice. Online cost control advice to ensure successful accomplishment of the mission for the given cost, time and performance. Let me narrate another incident which took place in 1998. In 1992, the light combat aircraft team had decided At that time, the country did not have the experience of developing flight control system. He chose LFCS, that is the Lockheed Martin, for the contract since America, since they had experience designing mission control system for L-16. Joint team for design and development of the MCS was formed with ADRO, India, and LFCS, American country. And due to the sanction, the American company broke the contract and retained all the equipment, software, and the technical information which were their premises. This was definitely a shock for the India team. Immediately called for a meeting of directors of National Flight Test Center. They are all our laboratories for multiple organizations. Professor I.T. Sharma, a renowned control system specialist. Professor Goshen, a noted digital control system expert and guidance control specialist for DRDO. This was allotted for financial auditors. Financial advisors. The MCS, their flight control system team explained which is the whole of the situation and what are the problems, and we formed a national team to handle. We had a full day, a national team formed the team after prolonged deliberation. We have a structural method by which the development could be completed, the system could be certified for flight range, overall, interior flights. Based on the recommendation, ADA was given the responsibility of verification and validation software. The Integrated Flight Control System Review Committee was constituted as a national team, and director and subordinate for the chairman for the team. And the hardware and simulation, this team went once in a week and brought in all the issues. They are handled, they gave the software. It was controlled by the chairman, members of each chain and all the vehicle, test pilot, flight test. This team also went every week and reviewed. We also introduced participation of certification agency and inspection agency. The aim was to see that the problem any system is brought to focus at the end. The confidence building took place by this and that test. For example, informal burn test, flight test was carried out. Simulating the pilot through the simulator for more than 2,000 hours. That's what we missed for the partner. We compensated by enhancing the critical design review and increased the test time to ensure same manner to design of the integrated flight control system. The entire team took the denial as a national challenge. They said if you are going to take more time, you will take less time. Even you are going to take $20 million, we will reduce. This event reassured me that no country could be dominated by imposing technology sanction or economic sanction. The collective power of the scientific and managerial and financial management team will defeat the challenges from validation. Now, MCA will be entering the production phase. I would suggest members of ICWAI to analyze such success stories, draw lessons for cost detection of indigenous programs. And friends, the whole system continuously reviewed. Now, for the past few years, I was asking myself what type of innovation needed to enter the Indian economy and other world economies which are presently in the country. That's every one of your minds. So, I had a question on this subject in the exports leakage of management after that. 2 days back. It came to the light that the Indian economy will be less affected due to the world financial crisis. One, there are three reasons for this. This is due to number one. Indian banking system has always been conservative, which has prevented the crisis. We are testing now promptly the developers. The liberalization process, which started in a long time, Prime Minister, has checked and balanced